Welcome to Azure Stack Fusion, a simple part in the Mercator software. So here you can see a 3D part of this isometric view of this 3D part, and at bottom you can see a 2D drawing of all. Now let's start to design this part in our Mercator software. So first of all, go open Mercator software, go to start, mechanical design, part design. And give name what you want to do. And actually we are not using this thing, so add this all clear. And create one point this at origin. And insert one axis system to this point. And now we start to design this part. So first of all, we will create this rectangle part. So go to sketch positioning, select this general plane. Origin as this point. Orientation parallel to this line. And go to profile tab, in this apply to this rectangle, center rectangle, and check the dimensions. So the length of this breadth of this rectangle is 53 plus 53. So your height has 53 plus 53. And actually the length is also 53 plus 53, means 106. Accurate is square. So it is now rectangle. So our square is completed. Now exit the 2D sketch workbench. Make sure you are in the part body depend of it. Use CAD command and select this 2D sketch. And check the vertex parallel for this. The parallel of this is 12. And select fillet here. Select this all corner of the squares. Make sure what is value for this is 10 radius. Now we have to create one circle here having radius value given as 22. Go to sketch position, select this ZY plane, origin as this point, orientation is this parallel to this line. And draw the center circle here. And give the dimension to this as radius 22. And check what is pair value for this. So exit the tool sketch workbench. Select pair here. And pair value of this is 108 from this space. Now we are creating this upper rectangle here. So for this, for creating this, select the front face of this circle. We should originate this point, orientation, add up to this line. and create one simple rectangle here. Here, and make sure to make this symmetric to this vertical axis. And length of this rectangle is 30. From center to this upper part, the value is given as 32. From this to this, give whatever value you want to do. You can go as 8. Now exit the workbench and check what is pad value for this rectangle. Actually, pad value for this rectangle is, I think, 76. Here you can see from top view of this 76 mm from this front face. So select this, go to pad, select this 2D sketch and make sure the direction is reverse, value is 76. Now our this part is done. Now let's start to create this side rectangle. So go to position sketch again and select this face. Position is at this point. Parallel to this and create one vertical rectangle here. Vertical rectangle we have to create here and make sure this rectangle is symmetrical this horizontal axis. Actual length of this horizontal rectangle is here you can see outside is 30. Actually it is not symmetric, so delete this symmetrical symbol. This rectangle value we can see, it is not given from center to this value 32. From center to this value is given as 32. From bottom, actually from bottom it should be coincide with this circle. So make sure to draw one axis or line here. Make sure to make this horizontal and this should be tangent to this circle. And this rectangle base of this rectangle is coincident with this axis, like this. And project the outer circle of this. And print this unwanted part like this, and this, and this outer surface also up to here, and make sure to fulfill this line up. And this line is horizontal, of course. Delete this line, vertical line. Now check the all value, all dimensions are fully constrained. So here you can see the all dimensions are fully constrained. So exit to 2D sketch for paint, and okay, here you can see that the parallel of this is 57 from this front face. So go to pad, measure this sketch as input, and make sure to reverse the direction. The value of this pad is 57. And now let's start to make here pocket. So go to select sketch position, select this face. Origin where has this vector point, orientation is paired up to this line. Now again draw one simple rectangle here having vertical length as 90 19, and the horizontal length means this act as a length is 6. And this rectangle is from side face, dimensions is given as 34. From this, they have 5.5. Now our sketch is fully constrained. So exit to 2D sketch workbench and make sure what is packet value for this. So the pocket length is given as 50. Here you can see. So go to pocket. Come on and make sure this direction is at this side. So we have to remove up to this part, matter of this part, and depth of this is 50. Press OK. Our next part, we have to create. Here you can see a hole, two holes actually. So for creating this, go to position sketch again, select ZX plane, origin as this point, orientation parallel to this line, and reverse this all. Draw from two circles. Name dia as 10 mm. This also same 10 mm. Center to center distance is 25. And from bottom, decent 15 mm distance. From side, it is an 11 distance. Now over this two dispatches will continue. So exit the two dispatch workbench and use pocket here. So this pocket will move from this place. So give us first of all direction. Go to more here and make less of this some dimensions. You can see up to this part only we have removed material. Now it is perfect, hole is created here. Now we start to make another part. So at top we have to create a hole. So now we can create this hole by using hole command. So go to home, select this face, upper top face, and don't forget to select position sketch because we are giving our main dimensions. Actually from this to this the hole is at 16 mm length, and from this extra length it is at 32 length. Now exit the body sketch, position sketch for pin. Make sure this hole is up to next. But before that we have to create this hole. No, we don't know actual value of this hole. So make sure to use blind, and diameter of this hole is actually 12. Anyway, increase some depth up to center we can take. Don't make this up to next. Press OK. The same we want add some here. So go to again hole, select this face, go to position sketch again, and from bottom it is an act as 644 plus 16, means from this face it is 44 plus 16. And from this part it is here at 32 mm. Now exit the workbench, and as usual our depth is up to center we can take, and diameter is 12. Now we have to create another hole which is at the center of this. Go to hole again, select this face, make sure it is exactly aligned to center. Yes, you can see it's exactly aligned to center. So do not need to go to the position sketch. So make sure our here in this drawing you can see this hole is flat, not flat at bottom, actually it is V type, and depth of this is here you can see our diameter is 25. So value is 25 and depth is 82. And you can see this one is exactly perfect. Come. Now we have to create this hole. So for creating the hole, Go to more command, select this face. Go to position sketch. Make sure what is value for this. So this circle is from bottom, it is at 50, and from horizontal also it is at 50 radius. 10 mm value. So from this also it is 50. And from this face also it is at 50 mm distance. Now exit the 2D sketch workbench and make sure this hole is actually counter bore hole. So go to here type and select type of counter bore and diameter of counter bore is 15 mm and 3 mm depth. And diameter of this hole is 10. This is 50. I can just go to preview and see. And don't forget to make this tag. And it is up to next. Now this hole is created, and exactly this hole we want at other side, other all side also. At this 4 side also. So go to rectangle pattern here and select this object and take our first direction is this. Go to the second direction, the second direction is this, reference direction is this. Make it reverse here and again go to first direction, make it reverse here. So from this to this, length is, length of this is, here you can see, '76 also, and from this also it is 76, and from this also it is at 76, because this part is square. So here minus is 76, and here also 76, and make sure to make instant here. Press OK. Now you can see a greater of 4 comparable holes here. Now you can see our exact part is ready. Just we have to give here some fillet. Go to fillet, select this part, this edge, this edge. You can see the fillet value is 5. Now you can see the exact part is created in this KTR software. Like this.